Hi, Kim.
Hi, Patsy. How are you?
Good.
Great.
Is Nick here today?
He's here.
Good.
To sum up Nick in a few words, I would have to say he's a teacher, a choreographer, a man of vision, a man of ideas. He's always totally thinking of some idea. It may not always have to do with ballroom dancing. Often it has to do with movies, or plays, or a song, or even food.
Hi, Nick.
You ready to work?
Sure am.
I hope we can get that step today.
I already got my shoes on even.
Oh, that's great. Let's go. And then soften it. That's how it's going to end up again. Gotcha.
Patsy Hutchins has been Nick's student longer than anyone else, taking lessons at his Oklahoma City studio.
Since I've been associated with Nick, we have he has produced several other dance tapes in addition to children's tapes. I've learned a lot about producing videos and working with children and the work that goes behind producing a dance video.
I didn't know flowers could talk. Where am I?
You're in the magic forest, and that's where I can talk.
But throughout all his creative exertions, Felix is first and foremost a dancer.
I've taught everybody. I've made tapes that have taught tens of thousands of people. I personally have taught Robert Duvall, Mickey Rooney, Frankie Avalon, Rosemary Clooney. The list is on and on and on.
Nick is a teacher at heart. It just comes easy for him. I enjoy the music, the rhythm. A lot of people come for exercise. That's not my main purpose. My main purpose is the creative expression it affords me.
Everybody has a desire to show what they can do or show what they know. Everybody has a desire to be recognized or acknowledged for any achievement, you know, some little teeny achievement or whatever. But we're afraid. We're afraid of looking like an idiot. We're afraid of not saying it right. We're afraid of maybe being mimicked or laughed at. That's what I like about dancing. I have seen people grow. Now, I'm talking about adults. Grow on the dance floor, change personalities. I've seen them go from introverts to extroverts, from inhibited to almost obnoxious. I've seen people just kind of change because of the confidence that seeps in. I never thought I would do this forever. You can't get away from it. I mean, if I hear a piece of music, I want to dance to it. If I see someone not doing it quite right, I want to help them out.
Counts are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, with 1, 2.
Today, Dance Magic has 12 instructors who break down ballroom art into manageable first steps for hundreds of Oklahomans. Felix oversees all, and don't believe him when he says he doesn't have anything else to do. Nick knows what dance has done for him.
I think dance has given me more than any other possible career could.
But he still has dreams to chase, Felix still pursues his elusive second love, shopping his theater scripts and screenplays to those in Oklahoma's entertainment industry.
The main thing is I'm happy doing what I'm doing. I went to Gray Mark, talked to Gray Fredrickson and John Simonelli, and they liked several of the screenplays, but they have a plate full already. They're doing a whole bunch of movies that they're busy with. So one way or another, I'll get it done.
Nick Felix is that rare breed of artist who succeeds and struggles simultaneously.
You can't stop imagining things. You can't stop storytelling. Maybe I don't put as much to paper as I should, but I'm always thinking of what would make a good story or a good title or a good song or even an incident in a play. So I don't think I'll ever give that up.
Felix vows to retire next year, but no one really believes him. They know that for this ballroom artist, the beat always goes on.
I think I just want to do everything as much as I can, whether I'm financially capable or even physically or talent-wise, I still want to do it. So let's just say I'm having the time of my life because I'm getting up there and I am still kicking butt.
Three, two, three, four, two, and three. Five, two, three, six, two, three, seven, two, three, eight, two, three, nine, two, and three.